Commitment 2010 coverage now. Wisconsin Democrats sound off about a controversial political TV ad running here in Milwaukee. New at 6, 12 News Ken Wainscott has been investigating the group that's behind that ad.
Yeah, it's a national third-party group called the Committee for Truth in Politics. A relatively unknown group, doesn't have a website, and has reportedly fought to keep from disclosing its financial information to the Federal Elections Commission. But an ad that the group is running here in Wisconsin is creating a bit of a stir.
The fast-paced issue ad zeroes in on government spending, using on-screen graphics to claim that what it calls a financial reform bill is actually a new $4 trillion bailout for the banks. The ad ends by urging voters to tell Senators Cole and Feingold not to support the legislation. But is the ad true? Well, the nonpartisan analysis group FactCheck.org says not entirely. The group says that what the ad claims is a big bank bailout refers to a plan that would allow the Federal Reserve to loan up to $4 trillion to failing banks. But it overlooks the fact that the Fed already has the authority to do that, with no limit. Today, a spokesperson for the Wisconsin Democratic Party called the ad misleading.
What I think it is a way to distort the argument about banking regulation.
Senator Russ Feingold says the ad is trying to distort the record. And in a statement, the Feingold Senate campaign says the ad wants people to believe that Senator Feingold supported Wall Street bailouts, when the truth is, they say, he opposed Wall Street bailouts. Feingold's office did not say how many calls it has received, but Senator Herb Cole's office tells 12 News that the senator has received just under 50 calls over the last few weeks on this subject. Of 8,000 to 9,000 calls, letters, and emails he gets from constituents on all issues each week.
And we also contacted the state Republican Party. The executive director tells us that the ad points to the fact that Americans everywhere want the administration to focus on creating more jobs, he says, not spending more taxpayer dollars. The ad is also running in a number of other states, urging voters in those states to call their own senators.
Okay, have we been able to contact this third-party group?
Yeah, we gave it a shot. I did reach out to the group's lawyer in Indiana. He's a nationally known political attorney who also, by the way, represented Wisconsin Supreme Court Justice Michael Gableman in a recent high-profile case here in Wisconsin, but have not received a reply.
All right, thanks, Kent.